And I was just confused. I'm trying to fight one, and one kicked me. And then my
I just wanna be your friend.
Honestly, welcome back to my channel. If you're watching this, this is the story time on how I got jumped in the 7th grade. And yeah, we're just gonna get right into it. So boom, 7th grade tonight is not the same as seniors tonight. Not, she's just not the same. So 7th grade tonight, I wanna be cool so bad, like pick me famous, pick me popular, pick me, like I was mad, pick me. So boom, so this is like 7th grade. It was middle school. I took the bus home. The way my middle school set up, it's like 7th or 8th grade academy, just 2 years. 6th grade, I was in elementary. This is my first time out here, like my first time. So literally, I take the bus home. I never took the bus home before in my life. Take the bus home. So to get on the bus, it's like after school, you go to the auditorium, and it's all these kids will take different buses, and you sit in the auditorium and wait for your bus to come, and the person will call you to get on your bus. It's like it's security guard, call you to get on your bus. So I'm sitting, waiting for my bus, and this girl, I'm gonna name her Taco. Taco, like, it's musty. So now you smell that? You smell that? I'm like, I kind of do. Like, it was a little must in there. And so Taco and her twin brother, Burrito, Taco and Burrito, just sitting there like, yeah, that's like, that's humming. Like, that's, and I'm like, yeah, it is. Like, I totally agree, because I did agree. Like, it was smelled some type of way in the auditorium. Taco takes it upon herself. Wait, this was years ago. Anything I say is my view of the story. Let's not make this into drama. Let's not do it. Let's not do that, because that's mad unnecessary. So, what I say? Taco is like to some girl. Taco is to this girl. I'm gonna name her Peta. So Taco tells Peta, Sanai said you stink. Mind you, Sanai never said that. Sanai agreed with Taco saying it stink. And Taco was instigating in this. Taco was instigating in this situation. So I'm like, all right, this is what you about to do? And I'm laughing, because I'm laughing. I don't think it's serious. I'm like, oh, chill. I ain't say that. Chill. Because I'm laughing because I really didn't say it. So I see Peta getting mad and, like, you know, getting like a little aggravated, and I'm like, I'll be aggravated too if people are saying that about those allegations about me. So they say that, and it's just like, that's just stirring up in the auditorium, like until the bus come. So the bus get here. I'm thinking it's all, everything's sweet, normal time, and I'm trying to be funny, like I'm trying to be clowny, class clown for what. So I'm trying to be funny. I walk through the aisle. I'm like, I ain't even getting the bus yet. I'm like, ooh, it's stinky here. It's stinky here. I'm doing that. I'm walking and to my seat in the back. And like all these 8th graders in there, they're laughing and stuff. I'm like, I'm so funny. Like, I really was doing a lot. That was unnecessary. And then I paid for the consequences after. So I go to the back. I'm like, it's musty, da da. It smells some type of way. I'm saying that. And I sit down, and then everybody's laughing, the whole bus ride. They're like, oh no. And then like this girl, one of these 8th grade girls, is like, LOL, I think it's them. And it was Peta and her sister Erwick. Seen that right there. Peta and her sister Erwick. They were sitting, and like they're like, oh, I think it's them, LOL. Sanai, you said it's them. They always keep saying, Sanai, you said. So it was just looking like me, the bad guy, when literally everybody on the bus was having the same agenda, saying the same thing. but it's always Sanai. Every situation, a lot of these story times, it's always Sanai. So I'm like, chill, because I see them really getting mad. And then now they're really getting mad. And Taco is like, and her brother is like, oh yeah. They about to knock you out, Sanai. About to knock you out. Peter and Erwick, the sisters that everybody was accusing of being musty. They're like, oh yeah, like saying all this stuff. Like, oh yeah, she about to do this. I'm laughing still. Like, ah, we stole the bus home. I'm just like, ah, just getting a little frightened because I see Erwick in 8th grade and Peter is in my grade. And I see them sisters sitting in the bus, a couple seats ahead of me, and I see them call their dad. They call their dad. Like, Erwick's really tight. Like, she's really, like, upset and, like, she's, like, crying almost angry, like, Hulk angry. And I'm like, what's up? We're not joking, no. So she called her dad and she's like, dad, she's really getting me upset. I'm really tired of her S word. I'm really tired of her stuff. And she's always doing this. And it's like, and then she asked her dad, could she fight me? And her dad gave permission. And she was crying and stuff. And she's like, she gets home. She's like, yeah, my dad said I can, so I will when we get off the bus. And I'm like, well, who got off the bus? So in my head, the whole time, I'm in denial. This is not happening. Not happening to me. Not happening to me off the bus. Not happening to me, period. This is not happening to me. This is not. I never been in nothing like this. I'm all talk at this moment. I'm like, this is not happening to me. No way. No way. This is not happening to me. So like, Peter and Erwick, the sisters and me, have had, like, drama run-ins. Because we lived around the corner from each other and we was childhood friends, on and off. We had, like, little run-ins and stuff and little arguments and, like, disputes with families and stuff. So the fact that she said she was tired of this was, like, basically saying, like, oh, like, all the stuff I've done to them and all this stuff. It was just, like, adding on. But honestly, if I tell it, I don't really remember it being that deep. Yeah, so I'm still like, that's not happening. Nope. I'm in the back like, nope. I'm still laughing, trying to be cool for the 8th graders. I'm like, nope. I have a video for you guys of what happened when I stepped off the bus. Honestly, the video is a short clip, so you can't really see. You can't see me. The initial grab. And dust, if you see anything floating, it's dust. You can't see the initial grab, but you see the math, like, what's, like, the last seconds of it. So I'm like, okay, here come my stop. She gets off same stop. We all get off the bus. I'm walking off the bus. I step off the bus. I couldn't even react. I step off the bus. I feel Erwick grab my hair. Erwick grabbed my hair. And I'm like, oh, no. And I just didn't, it was just, everything happened so fast. Erwick grabbed my hair, and then I remember just doing anything, just, like, hitting back, doing anything, like, just throwing hands crazy. Like, I was just doing anything. I'll tell you anything. So, it's too much going on. Everybody's in it, trying to break it up, trying to be in something. Everybody's in it. People's recording, everything. And then I'm in it with Erwick, trying to get her off me, and it's like a big crowd of people, like, literally on us, like, in the fight, like, people trying to pull it off, people just in it, like, just too close. Like, it wasn't even like us fighting and the people around, it was like us fighting people right on us. So then I didn't even feel this when it happened, but in the video I see Peter run up, karate kick me. So this is where the jumping starts. I see Peter, her sister, who was in my grade, and this is Erwick was in 8th grade, and I see her pull up and karate kick me, and I just don't know what that was for. She did that, and I was just confused. I'm trying to fight one, and one kicked me, and then my friend, I'm gonna just say her name because we're still friends to this day, and she was in my mukbang video, and I dyed her hair. I see Brittany get in it in the corner of my eye. Brittany jumping in, like, trying to help. I just see Brittany, like, do one punch, trying to help. I don't know what she's doing, but she helping. And then I see my best friend Jay. This was just a really op moment for him. He was in my mukbang video also. Why out the corner of my eye? I understand he's a boy, but at least break it up. Corner of my eye, he's running down the street to his house. I'm like, never. So then that's, they're all just funny. And here, y'all about to watch the little ending clip to get the whole.
Stupid people! We're going to show this to the principal. But it's going to run out of the way. Oh, look at Naya's hair. Look at Sinai. She's not even fighting. Yo, you guys need to get out the street! Yeah, that was lit! Stupid people!
Ting, and then basically though, through the whole fight, I really was confused. Like, it happened so quick, it was just like, just doing anything. And it just really wasn't a fight, it was just more like a little couple grabs, and it ended so quick. I remember going to school the next day, and all these rumors circulating. The tell me why the video was in all the Kick group chats. You know Kick. It was in all the Kick group chats. I'm like, nah, this can't be true. Not me. So there was all this stuff like saying that PETA beat me up. Mind you, PETA was, I didn't fight PETA. Realistically, PETA karate kicked. That was about it. I didn't fight PETA. I fought Erwick, her sister. But they were saying PETA beat me up and all this crazy stuff. Like, I'm like, wow. So I go to the office. They're like, why did this happen? Blah, blah. And it was just really over something dumb. Like, really over sensitivity. And I just honestly shouldn't have said it. If I smelt it, I should have just smelt it. I should have never said nothing. That was really a childish thing. But I remember I didn't get suspended. And PETA and her sister did. And that made me look like a pussy. That made me look soft. Like, okay, the girl who got beat up didn't get suspended. But I mean, beat up, I really wouldn't say beat up, because nothing was wrong with me after. And I remember that they were trying to press charges on me, but they didn't, because PETA had a scratch on her neck that was bleeding. But honestly, I wouldn't say I got beat up, but I would say it wasn't jumping, because it was 2-on-1 and it was just a lot going on. And honestly, there's no hard, let me say again, disclaimer, there's no hard feelings. PETA is very beautiful today, and her sister. And honestly, me and PETA have been talked since then. We literally had homeroom together the last school year. Like, I'm saying it's no hard feelings. This is just a funny story now. At this point, it's a funny story. And if anybody tries to twist this around and make this anything with drama, that's not it. That's just not it. And I won't entertain it. Like, I will not entertain it. I hope you like this story time. I hope this was entertaining. Thank you for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And check out my socials in the description below. And let's be friends, period. Okay.